In the northeast, Hartlepool was once a fishing village. There's been a lifeboat stationed here for over 150 years. To keep it going, they're always on the lookout for new recruits.
Right, so you'd, so when you use that bear, would you take the bear and write it down?
18-year-old Kyle has recently signed up as a volunteer.
Before I started the lifeboat, I had no experience at sea. I remember being on a boat once or twice on holiday and things like that.
Steve's in Northup, so if you click on head up.
At the minute, I've got everything to learn, I suppose.
That'll tell us how close we're going to get.
It's very hard, with the same navigation, things like that.
They are changing the same layout as Steve.
It's crazy how much there is to learn.
Keep off the green. It's usually a good way of putting it.
Yeah. Yeah.
If it's green, we don't want to go there.
I think I can cope quite well under pressure, but I don't know how I'd be able to deal with something if I've seen something tragic. I don't know how I'd be able to deal with that. I don't think I'm quite sensitive, I think.
A few hundred metres up the coast from the lifeboat station, a dinghy has capsized. Two men are stranded on the upturned hull. One of the first to get kitted up with helmet camera running is Kyle, hoping to get picked for his first ever shout.
Thank you. I hadn't actually been in a shout yet before that one, so I was very keen on the way to get on there. But I was a bit disappointed, I didn't think I was going to get on.
When we were getting ready for the shout, there were a couple of new lads already kitted up. Kyle was one of them. I literally got 2 seconds of looking at him saying, yeah, Kyle, grab a life jacket and a helmet, you're coming.
I just thought I wasn't going to be going, so I panicked a bit.
Just after they launch, an urgent update comes in from the Coast Guard. The two men are now off the boat. One has managed to swim to shore and safety. The other is struggling in the water.
When you hear a message like that, it always pricks your ears up, so to speak, and you suddenly realise this is serious. We've got to get there quickly.
With sea temperatures under 10 degrees, survival time in the water could be as little as 15 minutes. At the scene, just metres away, passers-by on shore are powerless to help the drowning man. A passing boat has managed to get a lifeline to the casualty, but under the barrage of waves, their engine cuts out. For their own safety, they have to pull back. The man's life is now in the hands of the Hartlepool crew. Novice Kyle's first ever shout is a race to get to him before he succumbs to the sea.
People in the water, you tend not to take your new crew. Certain jobs, you can't afford to have anybody dilly-dally around. So you've got to be paying slightly more attention to the new guy on the back.
One individual maybe
up ahead, they spot the casualty motionless in the water. He's just feet away from being dashed onto the rocky shore.
So is that someone there? On your bow there.
Go ahead, over.
Hi, we're good. He wasn't moving. Oh my God. I was definitely panicked when I seen him in the water and I seen he didn't seem responsive.
I did have the thought that we've lost him, it's too late.
Put him down. Move back.
Your heart kind of sinks at that moment because you've got there as quickly as you possibly can. You've done everything you possibly can to this point.
No, you're doing.
So it was quite a deflating moment, really.
Struggling to get the casualty on board, the crew realise he's tangled in the lifeline.
Throw a line on him. Out when the knife break. I had to cut the line straight away because otherwise we'd be able to pull him out. I did sort of prepare myself for what we're going to do when we pulled him out. I thought he was dead, I suppose.
Kyle?
Yeah. He looked dead to me. So it was very scary for a couple of minutes.
What did you take?
but when we'd actually managed to get him over and get on the floor, he made a couple of noises. That was the big relief for me when I heard him make a noise.
Right, let's get some oxygen on him. Straight down. Do you want to get the oxygen?
Yeah.
The casualty is showing signs of life. The crew need to get him to medical attention fast. The two men are cousins. They were testing repairs to the engine when they were picked up by a wave and rolled over. The casualty, Richard, stayed with the upturned boat, while Jamie managed to swim to shore.
I didn't get really much chance to think about what was happening at the time. It just went that fast in a split second. We were upside down and slammed into the water, capsized. What was instantly freezing, I knew straight away that we weren't going to last long out there. Richard was really, really in a state of panic and shock at the time. I wanted to get him onto the boat as quickly as possible, get him into a safe place. He was panicking, trying to keep hold of the boat. The waves were coming, knocking us both off, and then I was having to get off, swim about, get him onto the boat. Absolutely massive waves, brain off my back. Now, once I got Richard secured to the boat, the thoughts started going on to myself then, bobbing about in the water, realising that my core temperature was going to be vastly dropping. Thoughts of my children going through me and my grandchildren. I'm pretty much the centre of the family. I have two deaf sons, one on the autistic spectrum, and I've got to provide for them, really. Life basically flashed before my eyes, and I decided I was going to swim for it. I told him just to keep hold of the boat, do not let go of the boat. He would be pretty safe and help was on the way. And I knew I just had to get the swim in and try and get back to my wife and kids. Really, really hard, one of the worst decisions I've had to make in my life. It was a really hard thing to do.
Richard, all right, mate. I know you're cold. We're going to try and get you off the boat, all right?
It was after Jamie swam for shore, believing he had left his cousin secure on the boat, that waves swept Richard into the sea.
Once Jamie left us, I tried keeping my eyes on him to watch him go in towards the rocks, but he went over two waves and I lost sight of him. It was like everything had gone. It was just me. It was just me against the sea. I just felt like I wasn't going to make it at that point. I think my body shut down. I don't even remember getting pulled aboard. Apparently I was on both of the lifeboats that day. I can't remember. I've always liked living, but I like it a bit more now.
I've been thinking about what could have happened, and I don't think Richard would have made it at all. I don't know where I'd have been able to put myself. I don't know where I'd be now. I wouldn't be in a very good place without him.
Just 10 minutes after launching, the crew hand over a recovering Richard to the ambulance team.
That was a good first.
That's your first one?
Yeah.
For Kyle, it's a shout he will never forget.
Cheers, mate. Where is this go back on us?
Yeah, that day was great to help save someone. I suppose if we were there, I don't know how much longer we would have had. On the way back, after we went out for the boat and came back in, I thought I would defeat to do this on a day-to-day basis, this type of pressure, but after it was great.
Yeah, this is ours.
Kyle did brilliantly. He didn't flap, he coped well with the pressure.
Is this the paramedics?
Some crew members might wait months or even years to get a call out where they actually make a difference like this. And for Kyle to get this as his first call out, I think it's absolutely fantastic how well he did.